Hey guys, my name's Edward.
Jean-Luc Chatham.
My name's Matthew Renda.
Hi, I'm Rahil.
Hi, my name's Selena.
Hi guys, I'm Harrison Amy.
I'm Sebastian.
My name is Anita.
My name's Eddie Dicey.
Hi, my name is Nathan Mock.
Hello, I'm Jerry.
My name is Lucas Ramsey. I'm currently a senior doing my undergraduate in mechanical engineering. Where we are right now is the office for Panther Racing, which is a student-run club here at Pitt focused around a competition through SAE. SAE is the Society of Automotive Engineers, which is an international organization because they want to best prepare students, especially college students, to go into the workforce, whether in engineering or otherwise. They do these collegiate competitions. What we do is part of one of those competitions.
One of the first spaces that we have here is our shop. So in the shop, we do a lot of our hands-on work. So you can see here is the chassis that we're currently welding for this year's car. Other than the shop, the other space that we have is our office space. We're very fortunate to have this space as well as the hands-on space. So this spot we primarily use for composites. We're one of the only clubs on campus that does their own carbon fiber. We also have our own 3D printer, so we can quickly prototype and manufacture any small things that we need to make.
My name is JJ Slavik. I'm the technical director of the club. I'm an electrical engineer, and then I'm also a senior at Pitt.
So hi, I'm Rahil Farooq. I am the lead performance and data acquisition engineer for this year. I have been on the team for about 3.5 years now, and I'm currently a senior studying computer engineering.
I had no background in racing at all before I came to Pitt. The only background that I had was in high school. I did the first robotics competition, and I knew that I really liked design work and working with teams to really make a single goal. And when I came to Pitt, I was looking for something to continue that. I had very little interest in automotive stuff beyond just, hey, cars are cool. But now then coming here, it's really piqued my interest a bit.
I did not have a background in racing before I came to Pitt. I kind of grew up on a more rural area, so I started driving a car since I was really young, which was really fun. Drove ATVs, dirt bikes, things like that. My brother got really into cars when he was 16. Him and a friend had won a competition where they designed a Lamborghini, and then it was actually implemented, and I think that really sparked my interest towards cars.
So pretty much my whole life has been at the track. I've like sort of grown up around cars. My dad used to race cars, so pretty much from a young age I was, you know, around the shop getting my hands dirty. I also worked at a shop working on race cars. Coming and joining the team was pretty much like going back home.
We are currently taking our chassis way back there to sandblasting.
There's a few reasons that we sandblast. The most important is to clean everything up from the welding, make sure that any little bits of residual oxidation are off of there. Additionally, it is to make the surface uniform for powder coat so that it looks nice and pretty, basically.
So when I joined my freshman year, the way that I specifically got involved was I just was a pair of hands. So I knew that I didn't know enough to start designing parts and really contribute in that sense, but what I could offer was getting hands-on and using the skills that I had learned previously to then really help make the car and work on parts. So one of the things I got put on early was machining parts for the car.
What are we doing?
Today I'm currently doing a static structural and a thermal simulation and analysis on our front brake rotors. Right now I'm just kind of applying forces where necessary. We already did do a thermal analysis. That's kind of what it looks like right there.
I am currently working on the kill circuit relays and pinning those out. This whole wiring thing is basically all the electrical systems that need to go around the car. So sensors, power to the engine, power to anywhere else that's on the car, whether it be on the dash, up in the pedal box.
So this is the dyno cart. Basically, this is where the engine goes on so that we can tune the engine before it actually goes on the car. It allows us to tune plenty of things such as fuel map, shifting tuning, and it also gives us raw power values that we can use later on for validation of our engine system.
So I'm an international student. We'll start off with that. I'm from Sri Lanka. When picking out colleges, my number one requirement for a college was, well, obviously they needed to have a computer engineering degree. But they also needed to have an FSAE team.
What's going on, gang?
April 9th, 3:37 a.m. We have assembled the car. We're mostly all the way done.
And then what we're up to here is trying to get our first drive in. So we do a bunch of last checks. It's very different from the first start that we do and that we're actually driving now. So there's a lot more things we have to check besides just the engine. Well, all the safety stuff we have to make sure is right. And then before we run, we'll end up going through and doing all the other safety procedures for everyone. And we'll be running up and down the alley behind Betterdome. That'll be soon, hopefully.
Our competition in Michigan is a yearly competition. We go up with 100 other teams, so it's a lot of teams that go up and do this. The first day is set up, so you go through a technical inspection where they make sure that your car passes all the rules, that it's going to be safe.
At 6:45 now, again on Tuesday the 17th. So tech inspection happened. We had a couple of issues, but issues are relatively small, especially for this young of a team, so not at all concerned.
Part of that second day is justifying your engineering decisions and business decisions. You go and you get judged by a group of industry professionals. You have to really be able to explain and justify it. The third day we start getting into the driving events. There's four driving events total. Three of the driving events are on this day. There's an acceleration, which is a 70 meter straight. How fast can you do it? And there's a skid pad, which is a figure eight, and that tests your general vehicle dynamics. And then there's autocross. This is what people traditionally think of with racing. It's just how fast can you do a single lap. On the fourth day is the big event, which is endurance, just 22 kilometers of a track. That is one of the most difficult parts of the competition. Only about 25% to 30% of teams finish it. Unfortunately, we were not able to this year. So you want to make something that's fast, but that also means that it's usually as light as possible. And then the trade-off with making something light is that it's less reliable. So you're really trying to toe that line the whole time. And so that last day, the endurance is really the test of a car to its limits.
The Pittsburgh Vintage Grand Prix is a 10-day event here in Pittsburgh that uses cars and people's love of cars to help fundraise money for different charities.
We've been volunteering with the Grand Prix since about 2016. What we do for them is we help the Cortile group with all their parking and any of the logistics that they need. And in return, we get to bring our car there and show it to a bunch of people, and we get to go in the parade lap. And what we're trying to do this year is get an actual lap where we get to drive around.
Mr. Pitt over here, decked head to toe. Where's your pit socks?
What we had yesterday was an issue where I could hear them in the helmet, but I couldn't talk back to them. So we're gonna try to just test one thing before we go.
On the day, whenever we're going to drive it, we like to make sure we go through the whole checklist that we possibly can. So it's not a single person checking the car, it's the whole team checking the car. And you just go through and you'll check, all right, is all the bolts tight? Would you have any leaks anywhere that we didn't see before? Are all the fluids at the proper levels? And then we'll make sure that everyone that's gonna be out on the track knows what's happening, they know the hand signals, and then we make sure that the driver as well knows, okay, what route they're going, make sure everyone present knows what route they're going, so that way if something happens, then they'll know.
We're here with Lucas Ramsey. It's not quite a race car, and Terrence Favors is back there, but we're getting the ride like a race car. Look at this, ooh, we're in the go-kart, ooh!
A little bittersweet because this is pretty much the last time I'm going to drive this car, and it has been for me the accumulation of 4 years, and I'm excited to get a last little hurrah on it.
So when we pulled out, they were a little confusing with directions and stuff, so ended up I was just sitting by the barriers for a bit, which let the rest of the cars keep going. So Mirko and I had a decent amount of the track for ourselves, which was pretty nice.
The parts that we did get were pretty good. The tight turns and stuff, so we were able to really push it. So what we were trying to do this year was do research and development into electric.
We went from a CAD design of the accumulator segment, like the battery, and turned it from CAD into a real prototype in like 2 days, 3 days.
Initially when I joined the team, we were heavily lacking in the electronics department. And then now at this stage as a senior, we certainly have almost 40% of the team is electric, and now we're going to an electric powertrain as well, which is super fascinating. I think kind of the whole point of the club is innovation. It's a brand new field, even to professionals.
I'm kind of excited that we're going EV. We have been IC for now 35 years, and we see a lot of the international competitions as well as the US competitions trying to push the EV cars further. Right now, very few EV teams actually finish competition. I think Lucas may have said 30% finish as an IC car. It's even less for EV. So getting a reliable EV car is something that we really, really want to do. And I think we have the skill and the motivation to do it as well right now.
Myself and the other directors had to basically be down here all the time. In the end, I really do think it was worth it because of the retention that we saw in new members and also the involvement of those newer members. Seeing everybody checking the car because everyone had worked on it at that point was super, super rewarding. It was nice to be able to see them progress in ways that I knew that they all could.
The future of Panther Racing is exciting. To see where the team will be at and have hopefully a top 10 EV car would be really nice to see.
This year was a really good success for our team. This was one of the youngest teams that our team has ever had. 90% of our team members are within their first 2 years on the team, which is an insane statistic. Still, they're learning about this, they're learning about the applications of parts, how to properly design parts and stuff that they just don't get in classes. So I'm incredibly proud of this team and what we were able to accomplish.
The team environment is just immaculate, and I've just really enjoyed working on the team, and it's such a friendly environment. It's hard for me not to be here at 8 a.m. to 12 p.m. every day and just live down here because it's just such a fun time.